So far, we've had Darkseid, who had an interesting idea that flopped on its execution, Captain Cold, whose lackluster keyframes misrepresent him as a bored mook, and Flash, who fails to feel fast. What could possibly be worse than those three combined? Well, here's Adam, who simply refuses to animate at all. I really don't feel like I need to explain why this is bad, but for the sake of finality, let's just go through it, yeah? This crouch animation is literally just the scale tool from Photoshop. This is like Berserk 2016 levels of lazy. Even if you wanted him to shrink as his crouch, you could spare even a few frames to actually drop into that new size, or even use that after image effect that happens every other time he uses his power. There's this stomp move where he gently floats up and steps back on the floor with all the force of a cotton pillow. You could easily lift his leg and actually stomp his feet in the same amount of frames to actually sell some semblance of weight and impact. There's this gunshot where he just limply reaches into his crotch pocket and flicks out his gun without moving a single muscle in his torso. I've already talked about gun poses two different times by now, so I'll keep it simple. Either lean back or lean into the shot. This is the one time it would be okay to lean into your attack, and he just doesn't do it. Here's a set of moves where he limply reaches into his crotch pocket again and lazily drops chemicals onto the floor. Also with the problem that he only moves his arms and the rest of his body is frozen. This here is a missed opportunity to actually characterize Adam as a scientist, and also to telegraph the gameplay function of his chemical drop by showing you which of three chemicals he's about to drop. You could also have him try to shield himself when he throws the catalyst to show that it's explosive and that it reacts together with a chemical to show that you've got two unique poses for two similar looking moves. But my suggestions aren't a fix-all solution. You could do literally anything to improve these animations, because he's just not animating at all. If your only acceptable animations on your character are when Adam is a glowing dot on the screen, then yes, you need to try harder. But if you tried to submit these animations to a college animation class, you'd fail immediately, because this misses the entire point of game animation in the first place. To sell the illusion of motion, to convey gameplay function, and to express character. What really sets me off about this lazy animation is that Adam isn't even a base roster character. He's DLC. Not just any DLC, but Fighter Pack 3, making him the 7th character to be developed post-launch. Adam was released on December 12, 2017, a whole 7 months after the game's release, and they couldn't even be bothered to give him more than one key pose. They may as well have shipped him T-posing. Given the amount of time they had to conceptualize and develop this character, it really gives the impression that NetherRealm either didn't know what to do with Adam, or simply doesn't care. This is a habit that we cannot be continuing to endorse or defend, because if you let them believe that this animation is fine, if you give them that inch, they will take a mile, and suddenly we're gonna find ourselves back in the days of Coochcopter. If you were an Adam fan, then I'm sorry, but you've been shafted. I still firmly believe that it is not unreasonable to ask for better animation out of NetherRealm, because putting in the work to improve their animation will only help to produce better quality games instead of pretending that nothing is wrong. Injustice 2 could have the greatest mechanics in the world for all I care, but if your game animates like this, then no amount of story mode content, guest characters, facial mocap, or loot boxes will matter. If our fighting game animation fails to express character, convey gameplay, or feel exciting, then all we're left with is functions. And we all know how that turned out. And that wraps up today's A.B.I.torial, and as we head towards the inevitable reveal of Mortal Kombat 11, we can only hope for a future without fence punching, Kitana crouch kicks, or whatever this nonsense was. Feel free to give us a like, and let me know in the comments what you think about Adam's animations. Don't forget to subscribe for more anime and game content from SugarPunch, and be sure to check out our Patreon for early access to all of our future videos. I'm A.B.I., and oh, in case anyone was wondering, the turtles are fine. They have some back-facing profile problems, but that's not really their fault.